Hello, I'm Mr. Arnajar, a retired lecturer in rheumatology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I haven't been to any theological college or anything, so I wasn't drunk with the old wine of the letters. My father also was like this, and he knew this subject through common sense he learned. And he wrote many things, but nobody wanted to listen to him. So I told him, write it down, time will come when people will listen to what you are saying. So I'm doing that. So I'm honoring my father. So here I'm writing a book on One God, One Faith, and this is chapter number 15 on Heaven, Hell, and the Royal Kingdom of God. So we started with the Royal Kingdom of God and the degeneration. We are coming down, you know. We were in the high position, one with our God, Father God. Then as we became merciless or cruel, then we were thrown down, you know. So I will tell you in this video. Kingdom of Heaven. With the passage of time, beast Mammon raises his ugly head and the people start dividing the planet Earth on the basis of races and tribes. In this process, people started to fight with each other and the quality of mercy disappears among most of the people. Like, you know, the Egyptian who killed a chosen person, a slave, for he wasn't working hard. He was sick, you know, but he had no mercy on him, so he killed him. So then Moses took revenge for that and taught him a good lesson that you don't kill people, for if they are sick, give them relief. Be merciful. Same in India, we got Shri Ramchandra ji. They are the first prophet who came into this age. He also stressed the quality of mercy and told them that they should be merciful to people. So they were giving free feast, you know, to poor people, which we call yag. In this process, people start to fight with each other and the quality of mercy disappears among most of the people. Thus, they are no more saints, but the angels that had conscience, truth, and contentment. So that is what we call fall from the higher level. We were in the company of God because we lost one quality, which is the chief quality of our Father, is mercy. As we lost that one, we were thrown down. And there we are then angels. Because we obey the moral law then to the letters. This is Christ Thomas says about this separation from God. Logo 11. Jesus said, this heaven will pass away and the one above it will pass away. The dead are not alive and the living will not die. During the days when you ate what is dead, you made it come alive. That means what ate dead means this, the ego of your flesh. When you ate it, then you became alive. When you are in the light, what will you do? On the day when you are one, that means Royal Kingdom of God, we were one. You became two in this kingdom, fallen saints. There are angels. But when you become two, what will you do? That means we will strive again to be up we should go. We have been degenerated. So then the first prophets appear in the names of Moses and Sri Ramchandraji. They are called Maryada Purushottam Avatar of Vishnu. Vishnu is the preserver. Maryada means the principle of living, moral life, principles of moral life. So they wrote down, you know, or they dictated the principles of moral laws. Who laid down the laws pertaining to sound living of angels. Angels are those who are perfect in the moral law. And they are angels. You remember the Jewish man who said, I do the prayer, fasting, how could I be perfect? He said, give away the money, you have cheated the people, you will be perfect. But he loved Mammon more than God. Thus, angels being subject to law, they could sin by transgressing the moral laws. So the sin started from here, from the fallen angels. Angels are subject to sins. So the era of sin started, and King David of Judah tribe sinned against the wife of a captain. But in general, they held high moral qualities. And that is why a woman told Jesus that for being a righteous and merciful person, you are a true representation, son of David. Against the present crook rabbis, especially of the Judah tribe, they became very crook, you know, clever. They had the knowledge, so they became clever in this dark age. Thus, this was the era of wise men capable of running the political affairs of their own under the strict eye of the court rabbi. And in India, the equivalent of Judah tribe, the people of Khatri tribe, were so capable that this political profession, Kshatri Varna, we call it Kshatri Varna. Varna means profession. Kshatri is the political profession. Was named after their Khatri tribe to honor their wisdom. They had excellent law and order. And this was heaven. Keys to the kingdom of heaven were with the rabbis who applied the moral laws tempered with the mercy. So the rabbis were the super ruler. They used to sit in the court. King will do the justice according to the letters of the law, then hand it over to the court rabbi. He will temper it with mercy and give the final decision. Further degradation of the religious qualities of people, in which most of them were shameful and truthful, but not contented and merciful. That led to the era of simpletons. The rabbis, Brahmins introduce idols of gods and goddesses to impart moral education. Because these wise men, angels, they don't need the idols to be given the instructions. But when the people become simpleton, like childlike, you know, and they have no knowledge, spiritual knowledge, because the Brahman, you know, they kept the general public out of the knowledge of God. They kept to themselves. So, but when they so when the knowledge of the Vedas or other thing which was based upon mercy, so it was then given to the people, Moses' law. The Brahmins, rabbis, introduce idols of gods and goddesses to impart the moral education, because the simpletons, they are like children who don't understand things. That's why when Pandav, they wanted to test the powers of Krishna, that he is telling us, you know, that you fight against your own relatives, which was forbidden. And if you fight with your own relative, then that sin lasts for 7 generations, 7 of your rebirths, or 7 generations. So that's why, you know, they didn't like to fight with each other. Then Krishna told them that all these things come originate from me, because Shiv, Krishna stand for Shiv, you know, Shiv, incarnation of Shiv. So Shiv is the Adam, all powerful. Like Christ is of the God, Shiv is of Brahma or of Yahweh, the son of the Yahweh, and firstborn of Yahweh and Brahma. As once more people were incapable of appreciating the spiritual principles, his word, they started to ignore the seers, which we call them Rishi Muni, living in the jungles. So they were living in jungles, you know, because when the rabbis are good, they don't live in the jurisdiction of the rabbi, because what they preach is love, not to kill anyone. What the rabbis tell them? To kill, you know. Rabbis are concerned with extrinsic value, and the saints or the Rishi Muni, they are concerned with the intrinsic value inside your heart. So Christ Jesus came to improve our intrinsic value. So they could not understand, you know, these simpleton Pandav. They were truthful like Peter, but no knowledge. Once born they were. They even started cutting jokes with them, you know, with the Rishi Muni, you know, or seers who are supposed to give them education. They start cutting jokes with them, and they did not like it, you know. The same thing, if somebody cuts jokes with you, you are preaching gospel, and sometimes he's trying to pull your legs, you won't like it, you know. The seers found them no more longing for gospel, because they were once born, they couldn't understand gospel, you know. Khatris, they could understand gospel. They also could not afford throwing pearls before swine. For their hearts being clean, then another prophet, Krishan Baldevji, Niti Purushottam avatar of Shiv, appeared among the dominant tribe of Yadav to guide them through their political affairs. After the great political war between Kaurav and Pandav, this present era of dark age or hell started, in which most of the people had conscience and the element of truth dwindled. Greed raises ugly head, and the rabbis became crook and hypocrite to create mess in the society. So, you know, that is the, we call them the era of angels. Then later on, it became, because the people who are simpletons, you know, they can't be angels. So angels were only people of Khatri tribe of the Treta Yuga, Moses' time. Moses brought them back, and they were then followed the laws or Ten Commandments which Moses gave them to the letter, and then they became angels. So next will be Kingdom of Hell.